Yellowstone quakes today and swarms along the common mantle plume under Idaho and Utah volcanoes. And we're going to take a look at them, where these volcanoes are. They're on the mantle plume that connects from Baja, California, Mexico. As you can see here, that seven looking thing. It goes through Utah into Yellowstone, makes a horizontal western turn into Idaho. That's exactly where we're getting our quake swarms. That's exactly where we had our 5.7 in Salt Lake City. You can see here that cross-section showing the magma very close to the surface, as you can see that red body there. The mantle plume from Baja through Utah into Yellowstone, and then cutting across northward, westward into Idaho. Let's keep this in mind, and this is where the 6.5 came out of nowhere. Craters of the Moon area, where the geologists say that that could give a 7 or 7.5 magnitude earthquake. We know that that's the same mantle plume that feeds Yellowstone. And it goes through Salt Lake City, where we're going to see we're still having earthquake swarms there. Let's take a look at the maps. And this is Craters of the Moon lava, right there. This is the area of Idaho. So here we are at Seismo Berkeley, and we have all the little quakes as well. So that we can, they're not big, but this one here has a, it did have a, where is it? Three magnitude today. Okay, one person felt it, but it's, I think the biggest one was about three. Now, but you can see that there's quake swarms going on. Salt Lake City and Idaho. And you can see the line right here. This is Yellowstone Lake right there, just west of those yellow dots. The blue dots are the past day and the red are the past hour. And this is where we have, we even have the latest quake swarm around the San Jacinto fault. I kept on saying it wrong, and thank you for correcting me. One of my viewers said I was pronouncing it wrong. I'm so sorry. San Jacinto, right there, okay. That's part of the San Andreas complex, and we have an uptick in there. But that's where we have magma. We saw that map, in the map before, we saw it going to the west. Then we saw that cross-section that we saw going like the seven. That's the seven right there. That's the seven right there. And that's exactly where the mantle plume is going. It's one part here, San Andreas, the other part on the Walker Lane Fault System. And the other part here, that's the mantle plume cross-section that we saw before, and that's the shape that it takes, the seven. Now we know the Idaho, let's take a look at the Idaho volcanoes. There's nine volcanoes here. Okay, this is Craters of the Moon right here, Boise, but you can see they're all the way up to Yellowstone, right there. And then we'll take a look at that Salt Lake City right here. Let's go to the Utah maps, go in. Okay, that's Salt Lake City, and you can see that that basically over Arizona. Arizona has volcanoes too. Where are they? I just saw a picture here somewhere. Okay, they're in the other one, I think. Where are they? Okay, volcanoes of Arizona. Arizona, of course, has volcanoes too, but that's another story. But we're looking at this right now. Okay, these are eight volcanoes. And this is just about where we had our earthquake towards the border of Arizona right there. Okay, 1.7 at 14.8, let's say 15 kilometers depth. 10 kilometers is 6 miles, it's about 9 miles deep. 9 miles deep. I doubt anybody felt this. Nobody felt this. Okay. 9 miles deep. And a little further up. And we can see the Utah earthquakes as well, the volcanoes as well. Right here. A little further up. Basically, Volcanic fields. Volcanic fields. And let's go back to the map. A little further up north. Yes. Okay. Right there. Basically following the line of the mantle plume. And that's where we have our volcanoes as well. It's a basin and range here. We have magma underneath and it's stretching. And we have the Salt Lake City earthquakes as well. Part of that. It's up here. And going back to this, we keep on going through Idaho. This is Soda Springs. Let's keep that in mind. Soda Springs. Soda Springs. Soda Springs. Okay. Here we are. Volcanoes of Idaho. Right here. Soda Springs, Volcanoes of Idaho. And let's go here. Blackfoot Lava Field. Let's go to the Blackfoot Lava Field. Oh, Soda Springs. No, let's go to Soda Springs. Okay. Soda Springs is here. And that's the Blackfoot Lava Field. Okay. That Soda Springs is in the Blackfoot Lava Field. Right here. As we just saw in the map. There we go. This is where we had our one of our earthquakes. Right here. Okay. Of course, we had them even more further up. Oop. Okay. As you can see, going all the way up to Yellowstone in a very straight line. And then, boop, across, we had that 6.5 aftershocks are still going on. So let's go to the Soda Springs thing. Soda Springs earthquake. Again, this is it right here. That's it. And our Blackfoot. Basically, this is it. Soda Springs, Blackfoot. Lava Field Volcano. The Blackfoot Lava Field, BLF, located in southeastern Idaho, at the margin of the eastern Snake River Plain, is located within the graben of the Northern Basin and Range Province. That's why it's a basin range. It's magma underneath, so it's stretching. The crust is stretching. Though it's not actually part of the ESRP, it's similar in its mineralogy, geochemistry, and bimodal volcanism. But shield volcanoes are less common than in the ESRP, and more explosive volcanism appears to be prevalent. Ages of the BV lavas, Blackfoot BV, no, the BVF lavas are scarce, but they are believed to be similar in age to Gem Valley lavas, up to about 10,000 years. In addition to the lava flows, there are three rhyolite domes ranging in ages to about 1.5 million years. Blackfoot Lava Field may be a potential geothermal source. That's how hot it is. Potential geothermal source. Going back to the Idaho volcanoes, nine, as we said. Some are extinct or potentially extinct. Sorry, let's see that. Probably extinct. And these are one out of five. Shield volcanoes. They're shield because they're big. And normal or dormant cinder cones. And shield volcano, normal or dormant. And they don't know. Extinct, zero out of five. This one here is. That one there. Okay, one out of five. Another shield volcano. You see, because they're pretty high up, 5,500 feet some odd. And Wapi Lava Field volcano. They're all lava fields. And when we go to the map, you can see the beautiful colors of them. Okay, the aerial. Let's look at the beautiful colors. There it is. Look at that. It's as if it flowed yesterday. It's so clean. So black and clean. a lot of farming going there. There's a lake over there. And this area is only about 190 miles west. I pulled out too much, sorry. Okay. Yellowstone is over here somewhere. Let's see. Sorry. There it is. Okay. It's about 190 miles west of Yellowstone Lake. Okay. This is Yellowstone Lake. That's the caldera. And this is Hebgen Lake. That Z there is Hebgen Lake. This is where we had the 1959 7.3 magnitude earthquake. Okay, and we know that we've had the recent, you can even see the sort of like a, that's a salt lake right there. The recent quakes that we had, the 5.7 here, and then the 6. Out of nowhere, boom, and then hopefully that was a major quake. And now we're having the aftershocks. And this one here, 6.5. March 31st, night of March 31st, midnight towards April 1st, 6.5, and we're getting the quake swarms here, and there's Yellowstone right there. And Michael Pollan has come and told us, he explained that the only type of effect these nearby earthquakes will have on Yellowstone is on the hydrothermal systems, the plumbing, having to do with the geysers, fumaroles, mud pots, and steam vents and things, that they could change the plumbing there. Perhaps some of them can increase in frequency of geyser eruption or decrease, and maybe some new areas, depending on where and how the plumbing system has changed. And we'll keep an eye on that to see what's going on. So this is what's happening. That's the mantle plume that's coming from here. And that, of course, the western part, it's like a Y, as we saw on the map. Two parts here, and the other part here into a 7 formation. Oh, we just had another earthquake in Kansas. Kansas, you know, has 15 volcanoes. 3 here, 3 here, and another 9. 6 and 9, 15. Kansas has 15 volcanoes, and they're diamond-spewing volcanoes. That's why we looked into that when people, a couple of months ago, I guess 6 months ago, whatever, they were fretting with the sonic booms that they were hearing, and their houses were shaking from their foundations. Well, it's because it could be the emission of gas. These types of kimberlite volcanoes, diamond and precious and semi-precious gems, are explosive, and they have to release gases as well. So it could be that they're releasing gases. And we have to keep in mind that it's also a part of the mid-continental rift, going like this, like a horseshoe-shaped mantle plume. One part of the eastern part goes towards the flanks of the Appalachian Real Food Rift Zone, which is the New Madrid seismic zone, which should be called New Madrid Rift Zone. And it goes, the other side goes here down this way through Oklahoma, Nebraska, Kansas, Oklahoma, Texas, and then sweeps into New Mexico. They don't know where that magma is coming from, but that's been there for about a billion years. Okay, and this is the Pennsylvania quake that we had today, 1.3. Okay, I did a video on this a couple of videos back, having to do, because we had a 2.7 in Montreal as well after that. And 5.1 in the mid-continental ridge as well, the 5.1 that we had. So you'd like to, if you would see that, those of you living on the East Coast, we have magma here as well. That's one of the areas that would say, quote-unquote, Yellowstone-like multi-caldera supervolcano, VI 7 and 8 in the ancient past. Right there. Okay, so this is what's happening there. We see that they're taking the formation of exactly where the plume is. So I'll leave links below for you for this. Thank you. God bless you, and thank you for your support. If you'd like to join me on my Patreon account, you will hear content not covered by mainstream media. These riveting stories will be based on my research, and I will state my opinions and give my personal insight on diverse and controversial subjects and world events, events not covered by mainstream media, and not supported by YouTube guidelines. So whatever I have on my Patreon, most of those will not be on my YouTube channel. Please consider becoming a member today. More of the most significant and important videos will be on my Patreon channel. Your support helps me to continue my research and keeps this YouTube channel alive. And we depend on your support, your generous charity, because we help economically challenged families here in Athens, Greece, and Kapota, and we also help the young generation with university tuition and the community around our church. Thank you.